Jeff Messina. Been doing these videos on the mat with, and I have different black belts, and gonna do different coaches and even some of our Muay Thai coaches and fighters, just to give you guys a better look on who these guys are and what they're about and their story. This next one's gonna be with Charles Jackson. I believe he was the fifth black belt for me, from white to black belt. One of my best friends, a true warrior, done a lot of stuff in the military and combat. And he's pretty much the reason why I joined the Army National Guard, or just the influence that he had on me. He's a mentor to me as well. And hope you guys enjoy this. He filmed this, and normally we're sitting on the mat talking together, but he's in Afghanistan doing his work over there. So I hope you guys enjoy it. And yeah, that's it. Thanks, Charles. Take care, brother.
My name is Charles Jackson. I am a black belt under Jeff Messina of Revolution Dojo. I first started martial arts journey when I was a young kid, being introduced to some of the traditional martial arts, taekwondo, some boxing. But it wasn't until my senior year of high school, I enlisted into the Marine Corps because of 9/11, and I joined the wrestling team. And that was my introduction to combat martial arts, combat sport martial arts. I found out about Revolution Dojo some years later, coming home from a deployment. Once I got into the Marine Corps, I had been exposed to some jiu-jitsu. Oddly enough, my fire team leader was a friend of Jaime, our judo coach. Now, we learned this later on. And he introduced me to Brazilian jiu-jitsu. When I was getting fitted for a suit for a wedding, I ran into a guy who's one of Jeff's old students. He's a black belt now as well, Rick. He invited me down to the old gym on Piemont, and that was an experience, a different Revolution Dojo than many of you know it today. That is where Only the Strong Survive really came from. It was some of the most hardcore training I've ever done in my life. I thought I was tough, and then met Jeff. And he, with the most polite smile, put me into a pretzel in forced yoga positions that I didn't think were possible. And so I went home that day determined that one day I'm going to beat that guy. So, you know, 13 years later, I still haven't, so that's why I keep training. I joined the Marine Corps right out of high school. Joined the infantry. Did some time there, then moved on to a sniper platoon and did a couple years there, and then eventually, after about 8 years, I joined recon battalion, so became a reconnaissance marine at the 8 year mark, and then the remainder of my time was in a reconnaissance battalion. How does BJJ help my military service and vice versa? Well, it has been a tremendous help to me. You know, the lessons in jiu-jitsu are universal, but it is a martial art. And so when you look at how to apply technique and philosophy when it comes to maneuver warfare on the mats, as well as on the battlefield or in leadership or in business, you know, there's a direct correlation. It's also helped me to kind of have more of an influence above my rank, because you know, every time you get on the mat, it is a simulated, you know, level of combat, one-on-one. But when you talk about maneuver warfare, a lot of the same principles apply. So you get a lot of learning done on the mats that you can apply to your military career, you know, for what I did, which was, you know, combat arms and special operations. So I think whatever you do, whether it's in business, you know, like, you know, the Book of Five Rings, Miyamoto says, once you see the way, you see it in all things. So I think it definitely will help whatever you do in life. One thing I'm most proud of, and not to brag, but I'm not Jeff's first black belt, but I'm Jeff's first white to black belt. So no one can ever take that title from me. So as you guys get better and tap me out and beat me up, you'll never be Jeff's first white to black belt. So that's one of my, biggest accomplishments in jiu-jitsu. And really, that's about loyalty. So be loyal, and work hard, and everything else will work out.